pieces, guys. So first issue is, if you watch Scooby-Doo like I do, and you shouldn't, you know that most of the villains are in it for some financial monetary scheme, right? But if you think about it, I mean, like, do you think if they just, I mean, those costumes are so convincing. They're not just convincing to convince a bunch of teenagers that they're real. They're convincing to, they're so convincing that they make sense, they just make sense to adults, police, Coast Guard officials. I don't know, maybe if they just took that time that they spent on those really convincing costumes, and maybe like the time that they spent, I don't know, working on their cackle, and just reinvested that sort of energy into something, I don't know, less problematic. They wouldn't be, I don't know, pursuing a life of crime. But anyway, the thing that is worse than that, though, is the authorities. The authorities in this world are so inept that, I mean, if you ever watch it and you see Freddy open the newspaper, it's always police baffled, Coast Guard baffled that an entire freighter disappeared by a ghost. A ghost did it. And I don't really, but that's one issue. But the other issue is that the fact that they just overlook all of the crimes that the gang commits to catch these villains. Case in point, season 1, episode 1, What a Night for a Night, September 13, 1969. They, on a hunch, they come back to the museum in the middle of the night, trespassing. Shaggy breaks into a museum, crash lands, breaking hundreds of thousands of dollars of antiquities. Throughout the entire episode, paintings are broken, pottery is smashed. They fly an airplane through the museum, the wings are broken, all to catch an art swindler. And the cops are like, yeah, no big deal, it's okay that you did all the B&E and the trespassing and destruction of property, that's fine. Thanks for catching this art swindler. But the thing that gets me just so riled up is Freddy. Freddy is just the worst. The gang thinks he's super smart, and they let him just craft all of these Rube Goldberg-type trafficking mechanisms, and nobody questions him. Nobody's like, hey, Freddy, you know, your last, like, MacGyver attempt did not work out super well. No. They just let it go because they think Freddy's the smart one. And so Daphne's always the pretty one. Freddy's the smart one, Shaggy's the high one, Velma is the lesbian, which is not true because I've watched enough cartoon porn to know that she shacks up with Shaggy. Anyway, one of the stories, they just let him go and nobody questions him, and he's just the quintessential just embodiment of white male, like, overconfidence, and like, they always make Scooby out to be like the complete, like, the patsy of the situation, and I just don't understand why, and this is why I have to quit coffee. So. Thank you very much for listening to me. Up next.